Good morning to you once again. Thank you for keeping it urban. You are right in time for the weekend drive. With me is Dr. Hilary Vainomdisha, aka Dr. Love. How are you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I am doing well.
Glad to be with you on the show.
Yes. Thank you for always coming here and telling us about love.
Yes, you're most welcome.
So today we are looking at how do you handle a long-distance relationship. What is a long-distance relationship?
A long-distance relationship is where the couple, the partners in marriage, are not staying together for a long time. They have episodes and periods of separation and running their relationship from afar.
Yes.
When we talk of long-distance relationships, people think of a partner abroad in America, in Dubai. But let's begin from here. We have a civil service that does not put into account the integrity of the family. So, for example, the biggest common complaint in the teaching service is you qualify as teachers, you teach in the same school, fall in love, get married, you are given a house. From the ministry, they transfer the wife to another district. She goes, probably gets a house.
Yes.
You stay in this house. So these are two houses, probably, that would have accommodated other teachers, but being used by the same couple. And probably not even being used. The wife has to travel back to this district.
Yes.
And sometimes the districts are apart, so the movement is not possible. So you work in Masindi, your wife works in Kabale. So you have to make an arrangement to meet either at the weekend or after 1 month, or depending on what works for you.
Hmm.
Of course, it is worse if it is out of the country. Your partner gets a job in UN or an international NGO. All this new wave of CHEO, people going to look for greener pastures, the partner first goes. Or even here, you are in Kampala, but your spouse works up country.
And
so they go work for the whole week, they come back over the weekend.
And another situation of long-distance relationship is, I don't know whether it's new or coming up with the trends as we speak in this era, whereby you have a gentleman and a lady married, but then one of the partners has another relationship going on side by side with the marriage, but also has children, is a full-blown relationship with children, with lots of communication in between there on how things happen at home. Is that part of the new relationships? Has it always been happening?
That one, when we are discussing long-term, long-distance relationships, because it manifests differently.
Yes.
We leave it out because the focused solutions or strategies of a long-distance relationships will help those relationships when you first assume that there is a relationship going on. Because some people are husband and wife in name, not in reality.
Yes.
But those who are functional relationships, but due to external factors, they cannot live together, are those we are talking of. But sometimes we stretch it into the hypothetical long distance. You stay with your husband or your wife, but you're really not connected. You are not even talking.
Is that long distance?
It is
related?
Long distance. You're together, but you are not together. Physically, yes, but emotionally, you are far.
Yes.
It's long distance. To reach out to each other, you go through mediums. You go through your
WhatsApp,
best man.
For example.
No, your best man.
Oh.
You tell your friend that my mother is sick and admitted. So you sleep with your husband, but you can't tell him that your mother is in hospital. Mm. So you tell his friend, who was your best man tells him. So he responds, ask her, What is the bill?
Very sad.
So
there.
He has to go through and ask. So you talk to each other through mediums. You get it? That is also referred to as a long distance relationship of a different kind, but it's hypothetical. So let's say that we have the physical long distances,
yes,
due to factors like
the job,
money, looking for money. Mm. Not only job, but also business. There are,
yes,
people who do business. They go shopping in Nairobi, then they have to take mechanized in South Sudan, then DRC, then pass by home over the weekend to go back and repeat the cycle. So business takes them all over. We have soldiers, people in uniform. They are posted at war or in Operation Suja. You don't even know when he's coming back home.
Okay.
So those are people whose situations don't allow them to be physically together, but they have to move the marriage forward.
So, Dr. Love, how does someone handle this long-distance relationship?
Yes, there are two different types before we look at strategies. One is the elective, the voluntary, where you two people say, "Mbere ganye, we cannot manage, you go for cheyo." So you discuss the modus operandi, the how it will work for both of us.
Mm.
But there is where it is involuntary, it is coercive. You cannot avoid it. There was a transfer. Even if you refuse, you can't leave if your partner gets out of the job. If they are in the army, you're staying together in the barracks, and suddenly he's put on deployment. He goes to, where do they go? Somalia. He's going to be in Somalia for 2 years.
Yes.
You stay home. So, first of all, I must tell listeners that all relationships work. We have seen long distances, distance relationships work. What does not work, when it fails to work, we now blame long distances, true. But the most blameworthy are the partners within the long distance. Some people are naturally not wired to manage. We have people who have high libido. We have people who have high dependency. Naturally,
for them. They're also poor communicators, because communication is key in a long-distance relationship.
Yeah, we shall come to that.
Yes.
But let's first see the people in the long-distance relationship. If a man or a woman has high libido, they need sex. Mm. They will not manage. They might have the spirit, the need, the wanting to make it work.
Mm.
But the body, the hormones, their libido is high, their testosterone is high, the body demands for sex. So, bajuzako, they'll resist the temptation, but it gets difficult as time goes on, so they will be tempted to have extramarital sex.
Yes, that is cheating, Dr. Love.
As they wait for you.
Is it cheating?
It depends on the beholder. It might be cheating. It's actually cheating, yes, as you say. It is cheating, but now that is introducing a new topic.
Yes.
Secondly, they might be very dependent people, not high libido. They are not sexually oriented. They don't have high sexual temptations, but they are dependent people. They are people who are made to depend on others. If there is good news, they want to share it. If there is bad news, they want to support. If there is some anxiety, they want someone. They want to bask in the shadow of a partner. But you're not there. Emotionally, they are empty. They are lost. These ones will also replace you. Not for sex, but sex is the price they pay to get a person who can be a companion. They need a companion. They can't live far away from a companion. That is the natural effect. So if you are those people, a long-distance relationship is going to be difficult.
Okay.
If you are people who you are a person who has been nurtured in a home where a father and a mother have been together all the time, you do not know how a partner can live alone. It will be difficult. But if you are a person who probably has come from a single headed family. Maybe you are a woman who has been looking after your children, maybe two children, for a long time alone. Then you land onto a marriage, you enter it, but your partner is going to be away. You've been managing a single, yeah. So you have that past experience and you are fortified.
You're able to cope.
You are able to cope because of your historical factors. And you already have a coping mechanism. So you'll not manage, you'll not wrestled
affected,
down.
As affected.
You may be affected, but not wrestled down by the distance. Yes. In fact, there are cases where a long distance has made the family more stronger. So this will depend on the strategies which you've asked me. One, it must work. You see, it is a forfeiting of companionship, physical companionship, for something.
For other gains.
Yes.
Like money?
The money, if it is money, it must come.
Okay.
If my wife has to work away in South Sudan,
yes,
and I'm in Uganda, but I still don't see her money, the long distance relationship will not work. Yes. If my husband is away in China working, and I'm at home, but I still have to borrow, I'm living in debt, my landlord is on me, but I have a husband, he's away, I am missing, I have agreed to forfeit my husband in return of something that is not even there. It's a raw deal, you understand? So it must work. That is why if it is employment, there was a time when we had UCB, they had a law in their HR had income, that if you're married to the same person in UCB, you cannot work in different places. People started using it to get transfers. They post you in Uguru, you get a lover in UCB Maine, you marry so that they can bring you back or take your lover to Guru sometimes. Mm. So as if it's coercive, it must also work. It must bring the reason why that separated you. You get it?
In other words, the trade-off must be
you bring a good adding one. Up. The trade-off must be real, must be bringing in the utility value.
Yes, it must add up.
Yeah.
To
secondly, communication is very important. But now it is much more easy because there is WhatsApp, there is Facebook. You can actually afford to be far away from a partner, but together.
Yes.
You're briefing each other, you're talking, you know what is happening the other side, you know what's happening this side, and you become much closer than if you are together physically. Mm. There are disadvantages of physical togetherness, like frequent clashes, like that the long distance relation people don't have. The excitement of seeing each other at the end of the period, excitement of travel, the excitement of coming to see the developments, like if you've been on Cheyo and you're sending money, you're getting pictures, you want to come home, see our house. Maybe you have a house you have not seen or entered, you only seen the picture.
Together,
see the kids, if you have kids, you've only been talking to them. Now, okay, there is video calls, you can see their physical development. But in the past, you'd not even know. You'd just see pictures which would take 3 weeks to come to arrive. But that excitement of coming home puts a rejuvenation, makes the relationship new.
Yes.
There you get an advantage over people who are into each other's spaces and even getting fed up. Mm. So if you are in a long distance relationship, the trade-off must work. Integrity. Even if you get tempted, you must present a face of integrity. Because remember, at the default, your partner is suspicious. Partners on both sides
are suspicious.
So you must always, through communication, through evidence, through control of rumors, through control of your movement and steps, and try to present a yes, I'm still preserving myself for you. You may fail, but you must cover your tracks. The official,
you
believable.
See, Dr. Love, I'm just wondering, that you just told us that one of those key ingredients of keeping it that way is communication, or keeping it better, and also communication can spoil the relationship, in fact.
How?
You talked about if it's not good.
Yeah, if it's poor communication, will spoil.
Yes, will spoil the relationship. You just talked about a kind of marriage where you are together but emotionally apart.
Mm.
How does such a relationship cope?
Usually the problem is ego. Mm. There is someone refusing to apologize. There is someone refusing to see the other person's stand. There is someone actually refusing to toe the line. And that actually is in a transition to breaking up. So the first hope for the, such a relationship is for either or both, usually both, to want the relationship. Once they want it to be, for, even for the sake of stakeholders, a relationship has stakeholders who are children, parents, people who look up to you, society, at your place of work, those people who have value because of your relationship.
Yes.
So if you want the relationship to work, then you must always work on the sulking. Sulking is one thing that we dogs many relationships. And sometimes people sulk for weeks and
months.
Are
you talking about silent treatment?
Silent treatment.
Yes.
Which is, sulking is where you refuse now, you cut off communication. Mm-hmm. You don't talk, you don't greet, you are in the same bedroom, you are passing each other, you sleep together, you don't talk, you don't know where your partner has been, who is talking to, what's the latest anxiety or problem, but you're staying together. Maybe when visitors come, or when at church, you laugh, you do the acting.
Yes.
But when you come home, it is silent treatment or sulking. That long distance you put between yourselves can break the relationship. So the partners must want the relationship. When you want the relationship, you also decide that winning is not as important as the relationship.
Yes.
You might be sulking to attract his attention, but if it doesn't work 1 to 3 days, break the strategy, look for something else. Because
marriage is about strategies.
Yes, you're trying, and it's also about success of a strategy.
Yes.
If it's not working for some time, leave it. If it is anger, and genuine anger, try to work on the anger, and when it goes, come back to reality. Come back to communication. Because why is marriage in the first place? In the first place, marriage is an opportunity for you to face the world. We assume that the world is hostile.
Mm.
You need to survive in this hostile world. Face it and defeat it. But you can't do it alone, so you get a partner to fight. Just like a football match, you need this partner to score the goal. But if you have the partner, but you instead trying to face the world alone, in spite of the partner, well, then why is there the marriage? So try to solve the problem very fast, so that now you engage the world, because the world will not be any easier because you people have failed to. And then consider the partner as a partner, as a companion.
Mm.
Of course, I'm talking to the elites, but different people view their marriages differently. We have people who view their marriage as a recruitment of another worker, or a nurse to look after my children, or a manufacturing machine to make me children.
Mm.
But they are not married. You have a wife, she doesn't know what you do, where you get money, where you're going next week, your real names.
And the partner says that this person doesn't have to know.
Yes, and the man says, how can I tell my wife? She doesn't even know your investments. So you die, she gets to know that the other house was yours. She gets, even the men, some men are in houses paying rent, not knowing that their houses belong to their wives.
But very upset situation.
Yeah,
but
such
just as we close, Dr. Love,
yes.
I would like to have a word to people who are hurting and they are in long distance relationships because communication is not working out, or for some reason or another, the relationship has turned sour. and they feel like it is because this partner is not present.
That's good. Let's conclude with that. First of all, you know that your relationship is not normal.
Yes.
So don't act as if it's normal. It requires certain things. It requires constant communication. It requires presentation of honesty so that you can be trusted. And you know, when I trust that someone is keeping safe for myself, for me, I will do the same. There is that reciprocal bit. Three, a willingness to forgive, because the challenges are many. So you assume that you're human beings. Forgive, agree on way forward, like if there is money, if they've sent you money to buy land, but your father's house has been hit by a tree, but you have money, inform the partner that, okay, this money, I had seen a plot, but this has happened. Should I do this first? Other than think, let me first repair the house. I will tell them, because now you have broken trust. Next time the money won't be sent to you, it will be sent to a brother who will also eat it. And you are the first cause of breaking of the relationship.
Yes.
Then, but above all, know that any relationship will work, whether it is close, whether it is long distance, because what fails the relationship are not events, are not the nature of the relationship. What fails the relationships are the people who are in the relationship.
Yes.
If you wake up and if you get pregnant and you produce a child who has no hands, you don't throw the child away. You evolve. You innovate ways
of how this child can live.
Can live with
yes.
you. And you love it even.
Mm.
So if you get a marriage and it turns out to be long distance, like a child with that, you innovate ways of how the child can live the same way as a parent of a disabled child innovates ways to love the child and make it live.
Yes.
The good thing that is that human beings are adaptive. You adapt to environment and you change. We are not machines which say, if I don't have petrol, I will not move.
Okay.
I can only have petrol. But as a human being, you will not have petrol. You put in water, you put in diesel, you put in paraffin, and the thing moves. So have faith that it will work, and making it work is your duty. The relationship itself is a shell house.
Oh, thank you very much, Dr. Love, for always giving us these insightful ways of how we can cope with our relationship. We are coming to the end of this conversation, but we do have the big issue coming up on top of the hour with Lynn Komcha. And we are going to be having Miles with Brush Talk. Please do keep it urban. Thank you for watching us.